dolls, or shall I say, hey sisters. So you guys asked me, because I did post a little bit on Instagram and Snapchat about getting the Morphe James Charles palette, and a lot of you swarmed my DMs and said, hey, can you please make a video on this palette? So that's what we're doing today. I very fittingly am wearing my sister's hoodie. I had to have the pink one because obviously, duh. Enough about me. Let's talk about this palette. I have used this palette about 3 times now. I also created this purple look right here. I don't really know what to call it, but this is what we're working with here. Anyway, so I'm not gonna go on about a whole spiel about the launch and everything like that. I'm just gonna tell you that it sold out on the Morphe website within less than a day, which is crazy. They do also have this at Ulta. I believe they restocked it. I don't know if it's still there or not, but keep checking back on the Morphe site as well as Ulta. If you are a fan of James Charles, you know the whole shebang about where to buy it, how to buy it, all that stuff. And before I get into this, no, I did not get the brushes. The reason I did not get the brush set is because I actually do have quite the collection of Morphe brushes already, and I didn't really feel the need to have to add to my collection. I used an assortment of both Morphe and BH Cosmetics brushes to achieve this eye look right here. I have been absolutely loving the BH Cosmetics brushes. They are pretty comparable to Morphe brushes, in my opinion. Morphe is already pretty affordable, but BH Cosmetics, they're stepping up their game. Their brushes are pretty good. Let me know what you guys think of them down below. But I've just been using my BH Cosmetics and a couple Morphe brushes here and there on my eyes lately, and I've been absolutely loving them. They blend out so beautifully. But that also has to do with the makeup that you use, the palettes that you use, and everything. So let's first talk about the packaging. This is beautiful. I love his campaign photo. So gorgeous, just beautiful, stunning, like always. And it's just so creative and just beautiful. And then on the back, he has a little saying here. Again, I'm not going to talk too much about this because you guys have probably already seen his announcement video and his videos talking about it. So I'm not going to go all into that. Here is the baby itself. It says Morphe X James Charles. Now, as far as this packaging in itself, it is very, very similar to all of the other Morphe huge palette packaging. I honestly cannot give you guys like a side-by-side comparison of other Morphe palettes because this is my first one. I've actually never used Morphe shadows before this, so unfortunately I won't be able to tell you guys, yes, this palette compared to this palette from the same brand is good or bad. This is the same as this. This isn't the same as this. This shade's the same. This shade's not. This one's a dupe. This one's not. I can't really tell you guys that because I've never personally used any other Morphe palettes. So, this is my first baby, and it is huge. Okay, let me just tell you, I won't be able to take this palette on trips because it's so big. It will not fit in my makeup bag, and I don't want to risk it being all by itself in my suitcase because it could bang around and the shadows could chatter. So I don't feel comfortable taking this on trips necessarily, so I prefer like a more compact style. But the packaging itself is so sleek, so beautiful. I hate that it collects fingerprints very easily, but honestly it can wipe off just as easy, so it's not really that big of a deal to me. Opening it up, I love that this part right here is magnetic, so you don't have this flap just coming open and flailing all over the place sporadically. I kind of don't like that there isn't a mirror, but then again, I kind of like that there isn't a mirror. I don't like that there's not a mirror because this is such a big palette that you could stuff a huge mirror in right here, But that would also spike up the price because you would be putting more materials into it to make it, etc. Then we have the little tagline right here, Unleash Your Inner Artist, which is so cute and just, again, so sleek with the matte background and the glossy letters. Then we have the beautiful shades right here. I will say I like always cringe every time that I open this and push it back, because it's like when you first open a big chapter book or something and you have to crease the cover to get it to like open. You have to crack the spine pretty much, and I felt so guilty doing that. Another thing about the packaging that I'm not 100% comfortable with, this could just be me because I'm more of a, I'm not a professional makeup artist or anything like that, so for me, I'm missing kind of a spot to hold on to this. I feel like, as you can see, it already just happened. I feel like every time I go to grab this quickly, before I go out, I have to touch up really quick, and I grab it, and I find myself every single time sticking one of my fingers in whatever shadow is on the edge that I grab. I don't feel like I can like successfully grab this palette and hold it. And I even have small fingers, guys. Like, I'm only 5 foot tall, so I have really dinky little child hands. So I don't know. I feel like this could be with all the other Morphe palettes too. I don't know. I've never owned one, but I think they're kind of set up very similarly in the fact that there's not really enough space between the shadows and the edge of the palette for you to properly hold on to without feeling like you're going to destroy the shadows. I've dropped this 2 times already. In the 3 times that I've used it, I've dropped it twice, and it's already accumulated a couple bumps and bangs and bruises here and there, and it didn't even fall far, but the shadows didn't pop out or shatter or break or crumble or anything like that. So, thumbs up for that. But also, like, when I drop it, it hits my pants, and then all the shades go all over my pants, and then I have to change my pants, and it's just a pain in the butt. So, I wish that this palette had a better grip to it. Like I said, I'm not like a professional makeup artist. Maybe you guys don't have that much of an issue with it like I do, but that's just something that I find in just day-to-day average usage. I would want to be able to hold on to it a little bit better. But also, the size of the palette is, I love this, okay? Because with this palette, let's see if I can not damage any shades here. With this palette, it is huge. So it sucks that you can't really, it's not that versatile in the fact that you can't just take it on a plane with you, or you feel like you're gonna break it because it's so big, or it constantly falls out of your hands. It sucks in that aspect, but then again, look what you're getting. Like, you get 39 beautiful shadows, beautiful shades, beautiful pigments for $39. And honestly, for me, in my personal opinion, that is amazing. That is a really good deal. I love that, especially since this row in the middle, these pans are huge compared to like these little circle ones down here. I mean, they're all circles, but you know what I mean. The ones in the middle. That is brilliant. I love that he set this up this way, that these are the most used shades that you will use with any look. I love that concept. I love that you can use the white and the black as a base and layer the colors on top to get that gorgeous like depth. I love this. So, I will say, now as far as the formulas go, he did say that there were a couple metallic shiny shades, which there are, that are normal, and most of the mattes in here are actually pressed pigments, not eyeshadows. Like I said before, I'm not going to talk too much about this because he already kind of explained most of it, but with pigments, they're actually the literal pigment just pressed down, so it has a lot more pigment in it and the color payoff is gorgeous. However, it doesn't work like a regular eyeshadow, because with a regular eyeshadow they have to add different things into it to make it perform better. Now, the pigments have better payoff, but the eyeshadows themselves perform better and more easily. So, If you're a beginner with makeup, this palette is great, but also this palette will be your worst nightmare. It's great because you have all of this color variety, you can play with everything, you can create whatever look you want, and you can see what best works for you, your eye shape, your eye color, your hair color, everything like that. You can kind of get used to playing with makeup with this palette. It's very, very good quality for a fairly decent price, and it's just an overall great starter palette. However, because the pigments are pressed pigments instead of eyeshadows, they do take a lot of patience and trial and error, and you kind of have to adapt to the palette and be willing to put in the effort to work with the pigments, because they are more chalky, they don't blend out as smoothly as like a regular eyeshadow would, but again, the pigments aren't meant for performance, they are meant for color payoff. Once you develop the knack of how to like work with them and play with them, you will not be disappointed. Like, oh my gosh, I used like all the purple shades and I am dying. And you don't have to use specific other tools for this. You can use your normal makeup brushes. It's just about how you use them. Instead of swiping back and forth, you might just want to pat on first and then just pat it up to blend it out. That's what I find helps a lot. Also, it's really cool to kind of pat with your finger first and then gently blend out with a brush, barely touching the skin rather than like kind of going harshly with it. These shadows do have very beautiful payoff. I love them so much. Now, I know the one thing that a lot of people have been questioning is the pink shade right here that's called Skip. I've had absolutely no problems with it. This is the second time that I've used it, I think, and I absolutely love it so much. Also, remember that with purples and pinks and possibly reds, you're going to see staining, so also keep that in mind if you're someone who doesn't want something like that. Pressed pigments, because stay away from pressed pigments because they are prone to staining. I haven't personally found that I've dealt with staining so much, and it's weird because I am very fair skin, but I do have dry skin, so my skin doesn't naturally like absorb stuff much since it's not super oily. It's not like bringing in powders or like obtaining a lot of it within my skin itself, so I don't personally have a problem with the staining or anything like that. And just overall, my overall opinion of this palette, it is beautiful. I love, love, love the concept of the palette, and that James wanted to create something that was so versatile. Anyone and everyone could pick up the palette and do their heart's desire with it. And I absolutely love that so much. I love that you literally have red, orange, yellow, green, blues, purples, pinks, browns for your traditional smoky eyes. I love these metallic shades up here. I think one of these is called Halloween, and then the other one, I don't remember the shade name. Also, I hate when brands don't print the names on the palette itself. It confuses me. I don't really have a problem with it personally because I don't do makeup tutorials, so it's not like I have to remember the shade names or mention them at all. So as a normal, just everyday consumer, that doesn't bug me so much, but it does bug me if I were to film a makeup video and I'm like, oh, I'm gonna dive into the shade right here, but I lost the little paper thing, so I don't know what it's called. I do still have it right here, but it's just one of these little flimsy clear things that just lays over the top of the shades. If you're someone who doesn't mind saving the boxes or the packaging, especially ones that are beautiful like this, just sticking this in there is great, and then you can like reference it later. And yes, I am obsessed with these shades in here. I will say that this shade right here, this was the, I don't even remember what shade this was. See the struggle I'm having here? Okay, so this is Artistry. This is the Artistry shade. Now, a lot of people have been complaining kind of about this shade, so I wanted to address it right now. As you can see, it is one of the super glittery reflective shades in the palette, and this one is different than the others in the fact that this one actually has like reflective blue glitters in it. And this one, instead of being used by itself, it's pretty much intended to be used as a topper. So I'll go ahead and throw my finger on here real quick. You can see it's actually not super pigmented, But look at the sheen on that. It is so beautiful. So when you do swatch it, it's like literally nothing is there. But when you get up and close and personal, I don't know if you guys will even be able to see this. It has beautiful reflective glitters in it. And once it's packed on, especially with like water or a setting spray of some sort, it actually has a beautiful color payoff on top of other shades, which I love that because you can actually, sorry, I'm upside down here, which you can actually like take this orange shade and put that on top of it. You can take the green shade and put that on top of it. You can take the black and put that on top of it and create like a galaxy look. Oh my gosh, I need to do that next. Anyway, I just love the versatility of it. I think you can create so many different things with just that one shade itself by combining it with other shades as well. And also, don't hesitate to mix shades and create your own shades with the palette. It's like you have not only all of your primary colors, you have other colors as well. And you can kind of just create your own colors with it. For example, if you wanted a pastel purple, just take some white and then barely blend in some of the little purple with it and you'll get a beautiful light lilac-y shade. And that's the same way with the black too. You can deepen up anything. I used all of these shades down here minus this one. I kind of topped it just a little bit, but I didn't really like it for this look. I wanted to go for a matte look anyway, so I kind of just like X-named that one later on. But I did use these five shades right here down in this bottom corner, and they just, they're so pretty. Like, here, can you guys see what I did here? Like, look at that. And then, of course, I did use the black to kind of deepen up the corners and wing them out a little bit. And then I also have been using this shade right here. This is the shade Sister. I've been using Sister and Ring Light kind of together, as well as Face a little bit. So these three right here, I've kind of been dabbling with them a little bit and making different highlights, like on the inner corner of my eye or like on the Cupid's bow. That's not my Cupid's bow, that's my nose. On my Cupid's bow, my nose, my cheeks, etc. I've just been kind of playing with those as highlights and they are beautiful. Now for my fall glam look, I actually used these metallic shades up here, and I have to say this coppery reddish, actually this is more of the reddish, not so much, it is kind of copper. Both of these are beautiful. I have the Dose of Colors treasure palette. I can't remember the exact name of it, but it's the treasure one, and it has gorgeous metallic shades like this in it, and those are kind of comparable to this, but that palette is more expensive than this one and you don't get near as many colors. So I love that there is somewhat of a dupe to those, which is awesome. So there are those, and then I will go ahead and swatch a couple of the pigments just on my fingers like this for you guys. He did a whole video. There's hundreds of videos out there reviewing this palette that you can see actual swatches. I'm not going to go through and swatch every single shade on here because it's kind of pointless in my opinion, but I will go ahead and swatch this one right here. Beautiful. And let's do this blue shade right here. So as you can see, those two that I just dipped into are fairly chalky, and again, that is because they are pressed pigments and not eyeshadows, so you really have to work with them to get them to blend and do what you want them to. But they are, I'm trying to like do this so you can see kind of like what happens when they blend out a little bit, and I don't know, they are just very, I don't know what I'm doing. This is why I am not a beauty guru. These are my swatches, okay? Like, yeah. Anyway, with that being said, 10 out of 10, I do highly recommend the Morphe James Charles palette. I love it so far. I did also use this whole entire middle row. You can kind of see that some of them have definitely been used. And again, just because these matte shades are pressed pigments, I didn't necessarily have to go out and buy a whole new brush kit or new supplies just to be able to use them. I kind of just took the time to adapt with them rather than just like getting annoyed and throwing the palette across the room. I put in the patience and the effort to blend them out and work with them and kind of get to know the formula itself rather than just assuming that it's a regular eyeshadow and just going gung-ho. I will tell you guys right now that I was saying to myself when I did try the mattes for the first time, I said, oh, these are probably going to be just like regular eyeshadows, even though he said they're pressed pigments. I've used the Jeffree Star palettes before and I haven't had any problems, so I'm going to apply these like I normally do. No, girl. No. No. You have to really apply the pigment and then blend out rather than just start going really lightly, because if you start going really lightly, you're not going to get the color payoff that you want, and it's just, they're tricky. They're tricky. I'm just going to tell you that right now. They're a little tricky, but once you start to understand the formula and how it works and the best things that you can add to your routine to better the application of them, definitely worth it. Hands down, definitely worth it. I mean, look at this shadow. Oh my gosh. I am in love with it. Anyway, that's enough chitter chatter. I think I covered all the basics with this. I personally have had no complaints with this thing so far, other than the fact that I've dropped it and it is huge. But again, that is not necessarily a con because it is huge, and for the price point, that is such a good deal. I am talking way too much. Overall, I absolutely love this palette, and like I said before, highly, highly recommend. Let me know in the comments down below if you picked this up and or the brushes. Also, do you have a sister's hoodie? If so, let me know which one you have, and let me know if we are twinning. And with that being said, I am gonna go ahead and let you guys go. If this is the first video that you are ever watching from my channel, hey, feel free to subscribe if you want. Hopefully I'll do some more makeup reviews soon. I don't usually do tutorials, so if that's something you're into, I'm sorry, I haven't been doing them lately, but I do a lot of other weird random things. Clothing hauls, toy unboxings, DIYs. I do like the works on here, so if any of that interests you, feel free to subscribe and check out my other content. And for those of you who have been around here for a little bit, thank you for watching this video, and I will talk to you all in my next one. So until then, so long, stay strong, stay true, and be you.